Australia and the UK are a step closer to a free trade agreement, with the newly appointed trade minister claiming a breakthrough. Despite this, there are still roadblocks to the deal between the two countries, and it isn't clear how much it would be worth to Australian farmers and producers.
It started with chocolate.
On its Tim Tams at a reasonable price.
A free trade agreement might be just desserts.
The end outcome will be a win-win for both nations.
Australia's new trade minister flew to London for 2 days of talks. Reports from the British claimed the minister would be made uncomfortable.
Look, I had a very comfortable chair to sit in.
The two sides edging closer to an agreement that, among other things, could boost Australia's beef and lamb sector. But there's silence over the roadblocks standing in the way of a deal.
You've been given a scarce vaccine to come over here and an RAAF jet. Why won't you tell the public what the outstanding issues are?
Because this is a negotiation of a free trade agreement.
The government won't say how much it could be worth, but Boris Johnson and Scott Morrison could seal it with a handshake when they meet in person later this year.
While old allies find new alliances, there's no improving the relationship with our largest trading partner, China.
When you look at our part of the world, you look at militarisation of bases, when you look at the cyber attacks, all of that is not the action of a friend.
That remark by Australia's Defence Minister angered Beijing. Zhao Lejian accusing Peter Dutton of confusing black and white, blaming the toxic relationship with Canberra on what he says are Australia's moves to grossly interfere in China and undermine its interests.
We're standing up for our beliefs, and that will continue. It will not change.
Jonathan Kersley, Nine News.